In remote indigenous communities, it's often the elders that are the best source of local knowledge. Dorothy's teaching me to make medicine from the angry green ants found nesting in the local fruit trees.
Green ants?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's a tonic taught to her by her mother that not only helps cure a sore throat, but tastes delicious as well.
Who was the first person and what were they thinking to come up here now and have a look at this the way it is with all these angry ants and use them for medicine? Yeah. That's how you do it?
Yep.
Like a warrior.
Yeah.
That's a tin full of pain right there.
They bite and it's actually quite sore, but I've got to say, they're delicious.
Dorothy's churning the ants' nest in the water, bursting the abdomens of hundreds of green ants, creating a tonic that's a little like a flat lemonade.
It is incredibly like one of the best lemonades that I've ever had. It's absolutely delicious.
What's medicine for Harry?
Even just as a drink, I think it's delicious.
The Yolngu people pride themselves on having a strong connection with the land. Every bit of Elko Island has a potential to support the community. Even the most inhospitable landscape can hide a feast.
Yeah, we have to go into the mangrove trees.
Right into the mangrove?
Yeah.
Margaret's brought me to the coastal mangrove swamps to hunt for shellfish.
Have a look at how treacherous this landscape looks. What's that, Margaret?
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
It's a huge amount of meat.
Yeah.
These are going to be tasty. And you cook these just on the fire?
Yeah.
I can't wait to try this one.
Oh,
and he's ferocious too.
Just spirit.
Spirit?
Yeah.
Look at that beauty. These are going to be delicious.
Oh. So this is the elusive mangrove worm. Oh, look at it.
You can eat it.
I don't think so.
Eat it because you wanted to learn.
Yeah.
Aboriginal way of eating.
Yeah.
Just do it. Bit more. I'm watching you. What? Don't bomb it.
No, I burped.